One of the areas today that people are so concerned about, and we see so many books written and so much discussion, is the area of chinuch, of training and raising children, wholesome children, children that will be capable of fulfilling their potential and turning out the way we parents dream and wish and hope and doubt and that they should, pray that they should. There are many factors that go into raising good children. Obviously, the relationship between the parents is crucial, that there should be what we call shalom bayis, that the parents should live in harmony. Obviously, a person has to daven, has to invest in prayer in order to bring about raising successful children. But like anything else, when we want to look for an idea, a fundamental, we always turn to the Torah, because the Torah carries the blueprint for life and tells us how to be successful in all areas of life and where we should invest our energy. When the Torah discusses the episode of Yosef bringing his two sons, Menashe and Ephraim, to his father, Yaakov, who's on his deathbed, for a bracha, to get a blessing before he dies to bless the children. Yaakov calls them closer, and then Yosef instinctively lines up the older son, Menashe, opposite Yaakov's right arm, because the right hand has a greater potential when it comes to the blessing, and his younger son, Ephraim, is pushed over or moved over opposite Yaakov's left arm. Now, Yaakov Avinu felt that Ephraim is the greater of the two and has a different destiny than Menashe, and therefore when he gave the bracha, the Torah says, Sikel es yodav, he crossed over his arms. He put his right arm on the head of Ephraim, the right arm with the greater blessing potential, and the left arm goes onto the head of Menashe. But one of the questions the commentary is asking is, why would Yaakov Avinu, the logical thing would seem to be, that if the boys are not lined up the way you want them to be, simply ask them to switch places. Have Menashe stand on his left, have Ephraim move over to the right, and then take your hands and put them out normally, straight out ahead, instead of crossing them over. That would be the natural thing to do. Now, the standard answer given by the commentaries is, if you've ever been in a situation where, for example, you walk into a shul and you sit down, you're a guest visiting in the shul, in the synagogue, and you sit down in somebody's seat, next thing you know, somebody comes over to you, he kind of thumbs you out, you know, and he says, you know, I have to stand up and I have to move. It's embarrassing, you become self-conscious, you have to get up, you were sitting and now the entire shul sees that you're moving over, you're out of your seat, there's something embarrassing about that. To ask the boys to switch places would be embarrassing for Menashe, the older son. It's not only that he's not getting the blessing with the primary arm, but you're also asking him, please switch over, and now he's got to get up and he's got to move over. That's very embarrassing. But there's another idea that's mentioned by one of the great Hasidic commentaries, the B'nai Yisachar, and he says like this, you know, we as parents, sometimes we have preconceived ideas about what our children are going to achieve and how they're going to turn out. Jews are always stereotyped as striving for excellence. The story is told of the lady who's walking with her kids, and a man stops her on the street and says, ma'am, how old are your children? And she says, well, the lawyer is 5 and the doctor is 3. And as Jews, you know, we're always striving to reach the top, and we already have an idea of where our children are going to go, certainly in the Torah world, that the child is going to be a master scholar, and so on and so forth. So the B'nai Yisachar says, what Yaakov Avinu is teaching us is a very important lesson for parents and educators in all facets, in all areas of life. He's teaching us that our job is to reach the child where the child is. Cross his hands over, sikel es yodav, means he invested intelligence from the Hebrew, linked to the Hebrew word seichel. Our job is to do anything we can and figure out a way to reach that child where he is with his potential, as opposed to assigning him a place in front of us, and in the broader sense, assigning him a place and a mission in life. That's not our job as parents. Our job as parents is to figure out the potential of the child. If we figure out the potential, and parents may sometimes be disappointed. They expected the child that they brought into this world. They thought that this child, sometimes parents have a child's entire life planned out before he's ever born. Yet the job for the parent is to look at that child, make the correct assessment, and then do whatever necessary, crossing the hands, symbolizing you may have to go out of your way in ways that are unimaginable. But your job as a parent is to reach that child where he is, and then bring out his potential, and when that's done, make sure that you daven your heart out. Pray that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that God blesses your efforts with success.